the number one brand used by dentists worldwide. Brush like a pro.
Mesdames et messieurs, si vous le pouvez, veuillez vous lever, retirer chapeau de sucre et casquette et accueillir chaleureusement les membres des Forces armées canadiennes, le Calgary Stampede Show Band et Lindsay Kelly des Young Canadians pour l'interprétation de notre hymne national.
CFL fans, we now ask that you please rise if you are able. Remove your hats and welcome members of the Canadian Armed Forces. Calgary Stampede Show Band featuring from the Young Canadians, Lindsay Kelly, for the singing of the Canadian National Anthem.
Kickoff is next.
It's a matchup steeped in the rich history of the National Classic. Two franchises which collided six times in an eight-year span, including the 62 Fog Bowl. A Grey Cup legacy including legends Bud Grant, Ralph Sazio, Kenny Plain, Angelo Mosca, Willard Reeves, and Rocky DiPietro. It's been 29 years since Winnipeg last won it all. Two decades for Hamilton, the only two teams who haven't won a cup since the last time it was held in Calgary 10 years ago. Who makes history tonight? Great cup game. Special team player of the year, Frankie Williams, back to receive the opening kickoff. Temperature at game time now, 2 degrees. Just about ideal for late November. The winds are diminishing. That's Jay Langa back as well. The former tight end, Justin Medlock, to kick it off. And we are underway from Calgary. Frankie Williams tossed down as he crossed the 30-yard line. 18 yards on the return, and here comes Dean Evans. What a story he has been. First-year starter making his Grey Cup debut.
Here we go, here we go.
Big numbers in the Eastern Final. He's averaged 385 passing yards in his last eight starts. And they'll hand it off inside. Tyrell Sutton getting just his fifth start of the year for Hamilton, and he pounds it across the 40 up to the 42.
26-year-old Dane Evans will have a great receiving core. His weapons, the leader in that group is Brandon Banks, the MOP in the Canadian Football League this year. Over 1,500 yards receiving for Brandon Banks. The outstanding lineman, Chris Van Zyl, at right tackle.
Three CFLPA All-Stars on that offensive line. They get the first down on Sutton's second consecutive carry. And a tackle by Willie Jefferson. into tempo early, and Evans to pass for the first time. Guns it over the middle, and it's intercepted off the hands of Jalen Acklin and Brandon Alexander, the safety, with a takeaway for Winnipeg.
First start in the championship game for 26-year-old Dane Evans. He's played in big games at college, but this is his first, and you can see the miscue from the get-go because there was no play action fake. The ball just outside of Acklin's hands, and the first turnover and sudden change of this game. Shallow corner route. Safety that took over at about the halfway point in Brandon Alexander makes the first big play on defense.
Seven takeaways in the first two playoff games. A little inside toss, and here's Jadarian Grant on the sweep, getting to the edge, and has a Winnipeg first down. Bumped up by Richard Leonard.
Winnipeg Blue Bombers from the left of your screen. Jadarian Grant gets the first touch offensively. They'll use the entire field in their run game. You'll see the ball rushed by Andrew Harris, Chris Strebler, Nick Dembski in this one tonight.
Got 11 and a first down into Ticat territory. And the hitch here to Dembski. Winnipeg need him. Is brought down after a short gain. Leonard steps up on him.
Quite the journey for Zach Kolaris this season. Started the season with the Saskatchewan Rough Riders in play three in the first game of the regular season. Knocked out by Simone Lawrence. More on that as this game goes on. Traded to Toronto, eventually to Winnipeg. Played the last game of the regular season. A win against the Calgary Stampeders and is 2-0 in the playoffs as a Bomber.
Second and nine. First Kolaris pass, if he gets it off under pressure, and it's caught but dropped behind the line of scrimmage. There's Simone Lawrence with the tackle on Andrew Harris, and a headbutt from Harris that goes without a penalty, and the punt team comes on.
Well, this is the finalist for the outstanding defensive player in the league, and Simone Lawrence just hustling. I mean, he's a guy who had, in the first game between these two teams in the regular season, 17 tackles by himself. He gets an early one here in the Grey Cup. And no love lost between the two teams.
So no flag there, but that might be the last time something like that goes.
Yeah, there's your warning. There's your warning.
Medlock kicking outside the numbers, and Frankie Williams back to around the 25. A 42-yard punt by Medlock, so no blood drawn on the first possessions of the game. The Nissan Titan keys to the game brought to you by the Nissan Titan, ranked number one in quality by J.D. Power.
Well, a couple keys for each team. We take a look at the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Those explosion plays. Dane Evans had 21 pass plays over 30 yards, 18 of them to Brandon Banks and Braylon Addison, and stopped the run on defense. Winnipeg, the number one rushing team. Success on first down, whether they throw it or run it for the Bombers is important, and they've created turnovers all season, and they already have one early in this Grey Cup.
Ticats, the highest scoring team this year. Number one in yards from scrimmage, number one in passing yards. Bombers number one against the run. Ticats start at the 25, play action fake, and Evans in trouble. Jackson Jeffcoat crashing down, a sack, but a flag at the end of the play. Three sacks for the Bombers in the Western Final. Didn't have one here at McMahon against Calgary.
Major foul. Unnecessary roughness. Winnipeg number five. A 15-yard penalty will be enforced from the previous line of scrimmage and a first down.
Michael Shea doesn't like this call. It was a elbow to the head by Willie Jefferson and the forearm to the head on Dane Evans. Correct call on the the field by the official.
Well, it's a first down at the 40. Here comes the rush again, and they get him, the ball down, and still loose, and a Big Hill's got it inside the 15. The rush of the Bombers getting to Evans on back-to-back plays, and it's the second consecutive takeaway. Well, Jefferson, who led the CFL in forced fumbles, has done it again.
Yeah, the outstanding defensive player in the Canadian Football League was handed the hardware on Thursday at the award show. Willie Jefferson gets home from that outside. Inside fake, comes around the corner, strips Dane Evans of the ball. Two turnovers in back-to-back series by the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. And there in the green zone.
Well, that in one play is why he's the top defensive player in the league. Here's Andrew Harris, big hole. Harris, goal line, touchdown.
Canadian Football League. 3 years in a row, Andrew Harris has been the rushing leader in the CFL. And boy, he had a jump to his step on this first carry to cross the goal line. Sudden change, points off turnovers, so important when it comes to winning and losing. And the Bombers on the board first.
So two of the Bombers' biggest stars shine early, Jefferson and Harris. Justin Medlock adds the convert. And the Bombers strike first, under 4 minutes in the 107th Grey Cup game.
The 107th Grey Cup is brought to you by Shaw. Speed, coverage, control. Our best Wi-Fi experience. Shaw Blue Curve.
So the Winnipeg Blue Bombers have 9 takeaways in the postseason. And the fumble recovery by Adam Big Hill sets up the Andrew Harris 15-yard touchdown.
It's been a quiet playoff run for Andrew Harris. Semifinal versus Calgary and the final in Saskatchewan. Maybe tonight's his night.
Again, Frankie Williams from inside his 5. And he gets it back across the 30, stepping up.
Boy, Andrew Harris gets some help, Chris, from the guys blocking for him. First of all, from the receiving corps, Rashid Bailey, who started late in the year, gets the kick out. And Stanley Bryant, who was the nominee for Winnipeg, is going to get to the second level on Simone Lawrence. So well-executed play right at the point of the attack. And look at the hole that Andrew Harris has off that left side for the first points of this football game.
Get started at the 30. They swing it to Brandon Banks. Makes the first man miss, and Speedy B with the first down. As we set the Winnipeg defense for you.
Well, he set a record for knockdowns and was the outstanding defensive player. Already made a play on the strip here in this one. Willie Jefferson leads the D-line. In the linebacking core, the emotional leader is Adam Big Hill. When he talks in the huddle, they all listen. And in the back end, Winston Rose led the league in interceptions, had one in the West Final. He'll go up against Brandon Banks tonight. We'll watch that matchup closely.
15 for the MOP, Brandon Banks. First down, 45. Evans steps up, hit, open is Banks, and Brandon Banks is down inside the Winnipeg 40.
You just get the sense that Dane Evans has settled down. You know, he must have felt some nerves coming into the first championship game. His first year as a starter, that first throw to Ackland was just a little outside. It was intercepted, and now they've settled down. A couple of mistakes can do that. Get him out of the way early.
But This defense is fired up. Jake Thomas. Jackson Jeffcoat at a loss of close to five.
All-star offensive line in this matchup, and you'll get a lot of different looks from Richie Hall's group. He's the defensive coordinator.
And Banks on the sidelines. Second and 14. Here comes pressure. Evans pulls it down. Takes off. And gets cut down around the 37-yard line. Winston Rose from his cornerback spot with the tackle, and the field goal unit will come on.
Really a drive for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, Chris, just to get their feet under them. And the best team in the league with 15 wins all season long. Behind the eight ball early here.
44-yard attempt. Whatever wind there is now, as it has diminished, will be at the back of Kairalahu. And he nails it. Ticats are on the board. Midway through the opening quarter. Been eventful early here at McMahon.
The first quarter is brought to you by the Nissan Titan, ranked number one in quality by J.D. Power.
Bombers won the Western semifinal here 2 weeks ago, 35-14. 20-13 winners last week in the West Final at Mosaic. Ticats won the two regular season meetings. Winnipeg starts at their 35 after the field goal. Polaris on a roll, going to air it out here. Downfield and coming back for it. It's a great catch by Kenny Lawler at the Ticat 45.
Zach Kolaros has brought the big play back to the offense. Chris Strelder's the running quarterback, the two-headed monster, and it's Lawler on the corner route from that number two spot, and he's going to just win the battle when he wins the jump ball on a 30-yard gain. Zach Kolaros with a nice throw on the corner route, bringing his receiver back to the football.
Lawler a touchdown in the Western Final. Kolaros now 7 of 11 on of over 20 yards in the postseason. Here's Harris trying to jump cut it outside, but nothing doing. And there is Dylan Wynn on the tackle.
Andrew Harris led the league in rushing yards. He led in the 10-yard plus category with 40 runs over 10 yards, 100-yard games. He had five of them. Again, the CFL leader. There's Stanley Bryan at left tackle, the nominee and Western All-Star for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. Lost to Chris Van Zyl in the awards by two votes. Last year's winner.
And a winner in the Grey Cup against Hamilton in 2014 with Calgary. Second and 11. And they dump it off. Here's Harris putting his head down, and he is drilled at the 40. Well short of the first down. Carriel Brooks the tackle. And now the field goal unit comes on. And we watched the kickers at this end of the field. 45-50 seem to be comfortable.
I'm not going to for a second complain about the weather in Calgary in late November, because it's been outstanding for Grey Cup week, and I don't see it being much of a factor here tonight. The wind will slowly die as the night goes on. A bit of a breeze in the face of Medlock right now.
Brandon Banks is back, and Medlock misses a 47-yarder. And he has. Banks has returned two for touchdowns. Is he coming out? No. He'll take a knee. And it's 8-3 for Winnipeg.
Rear Intelligent Emergency Braking. Innovative technology designed to help keep your family safe. Available in the Nissan Rogue.
What's been coined the Drought Bowl. Winnipeg trying to avoid matching the longest Grey Cup drought ever. The Argos from 53 to 83.
when you break down the Winnipeg roster, there are 30 players on the active roster tonight that weren't born the last time the Winnipeg Blue Bombers won the championship.
Ticats take over at the 40, the spot where the line of scrimmage on the missed field goal. Tyrell Sutton, tough man to bring down. Braylon Addison. Addison with the carry up to the 48-yard line, and a guy we will see in that backfield, not just a receiver, and he fights for nine.
Well, it's tough to get low leverage as a tackler on Braylon Addison. He's a big play receiver down the field, but he had 36 carries for a nice 6-yard average, so he is part of the rush offense for the Hamilton Tiger Cats.
And now Sutton pounds for the first down. It's 5 first downs in the opening quarter so far for Dean Evans' group. Nikola Kalinic checks in. The rookie fullback out of York. First down and again Sutton. And Sutton bounces off first contact. Another first down run for Tyrell Sutton. The safety Brandon Alexander and Marcus Sales bring him down.
7th year in the Canadian Football League for Tyrell Sutton. 6-yard average and limited action for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, but you know he's hungry.
13 on the previous carry. That one contained. Big Hill steps up.
Had a great conversation with offensive coordinator Tommy Condell, who I think is maybe the best-kept secret in the Canadian Football League. Worked with guys like Ricky Ray and Zach Kolaros at other times, but told me that with Dane Evans, the one thing that has impressed him more than anything is the fact that when he makes a mistake, he doesn't make the same mistake twice. And Dane Evans will learn from that shaky start.
2nd and 9. Bombers show a 3-man front. Send an extra man. And Banks comes back to the football for a catch. Let's see where they mark him. Looks like they're going to spot him short of the first down. Julian Hauser, the starting defensive end for Hamilton, already headed off after that crushing block by Rasheed Bailey on the Harris touchdown.
That was a confident throw from Dean Evans, stepping into that deep curl and delivering a strike.
But it's 3rd and 1. David Watford comes in at a couple of touchdown sneaks last week. Remember the goal line stand for Winnipeg. 8 yards. Straight ahead, and I'm not sure. Not a big surge behind Mike Filer and Darius Scirocco. Ticats again were not stopped on a 3rd down gamble this year.
Well, it was almost inside of a yard, and that initial push, you have to give a yard in the Canadian Football League. It goes just off the right side behind Mike Filer, the center, and Darius Scirocco. It's going to be very close in this measurement.
Yard sticks out. They're short. 3rd turnover of the first quarter. And that Blue Bomber front has come up with yet another stop. The big goal line stand to get them here. And another big defensive stand here. Bringing home a Grey Cup to Winnipeg as a special meeting for a couple of the local products for the Blue Bombers. Here's Sarah Orleski.
Absolutely, Chris. There's no shortage of excitement for this game, and that includes the high school of Oak Park. Now, they held a pep rally on Friday. Not only shows their support for the Bombers, but 3 players on the Bombers that graduated from their football program. Andrew Harris, Nick Dembski, and Brady Oliveira. Now, Oliveira's been injured for most of this season, but Harris and Dembski have both spoken about the desire to bring the cup back to Winnipeg. Dembski's most vivid playoff memory was 2011. Freezing in the stands, he said, when Chris Garrett broke out for 190 yards on the ground and the Bombers defeated of all teams, the Ticats. And Harris has made no secret since signing with the team in 2016 that one of the big reasons was to help his hometown end the drought.
Oak Park's got a touchdown already in the game. Polaros under duress to Garrett Davis chasing him, but gets it out and Harris ducks a second man miss and is able to advance it close to the 40 when it looked like they might lose yards.
Zach Collaros does a great job when he spills the pocket of creativity. He's just keeping his eyes downfield and trying to find a target. It breaks down for him. He wanted to go to Darvin Adams on that short corner route, the deep throw, but it broke down on him. He spilled the pocket and got it out to his relief valve and Andrew Harris, who does the heavy lifting after that.
70 catches during the regular season. There's Jagarrett Davis in his fourth consecutive Grey Cup. Winner last year with Calgary. Short drop. Collaros over the middle, incomplete. Looked like it was intended for Lawler. Mike Miller was in the area, but the punt team comes on. First incompletion for Collaros after six straight.
There is your special teams player of the year, Frankie Williams.
And I think what's amazing about that, Suits played it just about every snap on defense, too.
Absolutely. All-star in the corner.
Fields this around the 28th. And Williams with a decent return up across the 45. Let's go down to the sidelines on the Hamilton side for Matthew Schenetti.
Guys, Brandon Banks has been through so much in this MOP season. Last year, he had 9 pins in a plate inserted into his left shoulder blade. And in the offseason, during a workout, that shoulder blade actually turned. The blade actually turned, causing his shoulder blades to be uneven. The plate causes so much discomfort when he sleeps and when he is trying to play, when he puts his pads on. And last week, I asked him, when he made that touchdown grab, how did you feel? He said, I'm running on adrenaline, guys.
Smallest guy in the league, but maybe as tough as anybody. And Evan shows you a strong arm, and he got it to Banks. And Brandon Banks has his third catch of this opening quarter and close to another first down.
Yeah, so tough to handle Brandon Banks because he's become an all-around receiver. I mean, he's got the speed. It's in his nickname, Speedy B. And that is already a challenge for defensive backs, in this case, Mike Jones. But he gets you out of your back pedal so quickly. You've got to protect against the deep ball against number 16, and that's when he breaks his route off.
It's actually 4 catches for Banks, all 4 completions for Evans, who sneaks off the left side for the first down.
So it's quite the chess match when you look at Tommy Condell calling the offensive plays for Dane Evans in the huddle up against Richie Hall, the defensive coordinator for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. And what does Hall try and do to try and contain Brandon Banks? You can double team him, but that would leave Braylon Addison in a one-on-one.
Final play of this opening quarter, and it's Addison taking the pinch, and he'll run for another first down. So the Ticats getting some traction here in the late stages of the first quarter. I'm a champion. Teams that have won the turnover battle in the Grey Cup have won 23 of the last 24 games. Turnovers, the story of that first quarter.
Well, they came fast and furious for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. Great play on the defensive side, a turnover on downs, an interception, a strip by Willie Jefferson. But as important as the turnovers are, the points off them matter as well. And of the 3 turnovers, Winnipeg scored the 1 touchdown. It feels like Hamilton has settled down a little bit. Dane Evans looked better as the quarter went on.
Good news for the Ticats. They lost the turnover battle 5 times this year. They went 4-1. They've got a first down into Winnipeg territory at the Connor 39. Here comes that big rush. Completely trying to screen it inside to Addison.
Right now, both tackles for the Hamilton Tiger Cats are having problems containing the 2 defensive ends for Winnipeg. Willie Jefferson, we already talked about. That's your defensive player of the year. But you better not fall asleep on Jackson Jeffcoat on the other side.
2nd and 10. splits. Here he comes. Evans underneath and incomplete. Luke Tasker broken up by Marcus Sales.
Great close by the Bomber halfback. Three interceptions on the season. Stays in the hip pocket of this crossing route from Luke Tasker. Tasker had a tough year with injuries. That's a great strip. Outstanding defense by Marcus Sales.
O'Hara Lahu surveys a 47-yarder. But the same as what Medlock just missed. O'Hara Lahu does not. And it's now a two-point Winnipeg lead. Before their names were household names, before the spotlight, the records and the awards, before they were legends, hockey's biggest stars play in the World Juniors on TSN. Don't miss the future of hockey beginning Boxing Day with a must-see Canada-U.S. rivalry matchup only on TSN with Gord Miller, Ray Ferraro, set to bring you all the action. Never been a season. Regular season for Hamilton like 2019.
Yeah, record breaker. Orlando Steinauer led the team to 15 wins. And if not for a miraculous blocked field goal against Calgary, they win 12 of their last 12. Including the playoff game against the Edmonton Eskimos in the East Final. The caretaker.
He's uncomfortable with that term, but he wants to be called the caretaker.
Well, both these fan bases, boy, it's been a long time coming. And you can tell that both can actually taste the championship. Good start defensively for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. They're on point there, making it very tough for that Hamilton explosive offense.
Bombers off for the kick return. And it will be Nick Taylor from the six. And they fake the reverse. And Taylor back to about the 28. Could have started at the 35, but with Jannari and Grant back there, they'll take their chances.
Matt Nichols started the season, was injured. At that time, Zach Collaros was playing on a different team. He started the very last game of the regular season for Winnipeg, that against the Calgary Stampeders. They had a bye in the final week, so a bye before the playoff round. But he's gone 3-0 with the Bombers, and that explosion play is back in that offense.
Inside, and Harris lowers his shoulders, and he pounds close to a first down.
And two things from Andrew Harris. He's running hard. He knew that was going to happen. But I like the way he's protecting the football as well. He felt contact at the end of this run, got good blocking up front, and as he did, he protected the football with both hands.
Won a cup as a rookie with BC in 2011. Looking for his second. 10-yard rush for Harris. First down, Collaros. Got a connection. Getting it, Waller's got it.
Now, we haven't seen it yet in this game, but throughout the playoffs and throughout the season, we've seen the Streb package. That's Chris Strebler, who on cue is going to come in, run the offense, and he's the running quarterback in the system.
It's interesting that they sent him in here because it was a first down. There was a delay as if maybe it was going to be second and short, which is automatic, but they're going to get him into the game anyway.
Well, usually he starts in that short yardage formation and then they leave him in as the series continues, but give him a shot now.
The story of the West semi. And he's going to throw. And on the roll. In the postseason.
Well, he completed 67% of his passes in the regular season when he came in as the starter for Matt Nichols. So he can throw the football. Nice comeback route, 11-yard gain by Kenny Lawler.
82 yards rushing in the Western semifinal here under the icy conditions of a couple of weeks ago. Three straight first downs. They take the jet sweep in. Strebler straight ahead. And there's an example of why he puts defenses in a bind. First contact, and he still gets five or six.
Well, Paul Appelese, the offensive coordinator, Chris, does a couple things to put the defense in the bind. One, he's got Nick Dembski running on that fly sweep motion. That widens the defensive line, and then he runs Strebler or Andrew Harris between the tackles. So you're almost trying to pick your poison if you're playing defense against that run system. Let's go.
Just limped off. He's been having ankle or foot problems for weeks now. But we'll see him again. Second and four. Harris releases, takes the pass, and Andrew Harris has got a first down. Yards after catch for 33, who had 70 receptions during the regular season.
Andrew Harris is feeling it. You can see it. And he's going to get the ball more as this game goes on because he's in that zone. He set up the Hamilton defense and tacklers by lowering his pad level in the first few runs, and then that time he makes a move in the open field. Maybe his best move is the spin move, and we're sure to see that tonight, but he loves that stiff arm.
Seven touches, 41 yards for Harris so far. First down. Polaris unloading. He wants Dembski. And a great play by the safety, Tunde Adeleke, to break it up.
Eastern All-Star at safety, Tunde Adeleke, makes a big play on the deep ball. A great conversation with him during the week, and told me that it was his high school coach at St. Francis Xavier, Coach Jennings, that first of all treated him as a person first and a player second, taught him the fundamentals. I think this guy's going to be a starting all-star safety in the league for years to come. That's a tremendous play, winning the jump ball over Dembski.
Former Stamp in his third consecutive Grey Cup game. 1-1. Second and 10. And that screen out of the reach of Harris. And the drive stalls.
Yeah, I think just Dylan Wynn and that push from the interior of the defensive line, it forced Zach Collaros to try and throw it around and over the rush. And that just floated the football. Watch the push up front by number 98 in the middle of your screen. He's going to get that great push up the middle. And Dylan Wynn's had an all-star season. And that just forces Collaros to throw it around the rush.
The Medlock miss in the first quarter, his first after 20 consecutive and 12 straight in the postseason. From 45 out, he doesn't miss two in a row very often. So the Bomber lead back to five here, just past the 5-minute mark of the second quarter in the 107th Grey Cup game.
The second quarter is brought to you by BDC, the only bank 100% for entrepreneurs.
Eleventh meeting between Winnipeg and Hamilton in the Grey Cup game. Bombers have won six. Dean Evans starts at the 35. And pressure coming again. It's Drake Nevis, the defensive tackle, and a Ford's high cat who gets home.
Working on Sirocco up front. Drake Nevis, three sacks in the regular season. He's in that four-point stance, that track stance. Gets out of that quickly and just rips that right arm underneath. It's supposed to be a screen, so the front offensive line is taking a two count and then releasing. That was too quick.
Second and 17, back at the 28. More time for Evans. Underneath it goes. And Kyrie Wilson tracks down Brandon Banks.
I tell you right now, that Winnipeg front four, well, let's say it's the front seven, is dominating this football game. Whether they're trying to run screen draw, which is how you counter a good pass rush, you go screen draw, or you're trying to hit these crossers, trying to move it down the field in second and long, the line is forcing Dane Evans off his launch point.
First game for the explosive Jadarian Grant against Hamilton. Here he is on the return. This is what he'll do. Across midfield and down to the 50-yard line. Three touchdown returns of punts. The leading punt returner in the Canadian Football League. And only Curtis Newton was able to stop him. The Bomber defense making some noise in the opening half here in Calgary. Canadian Football League lost a very important man last week. Ed Jalepka played 100 games over 7 years with the Ticats and a Grey Cup winner in 1972, but also the head of the Canadian Football League Players Association, managing director of the Canadian Football Hall of Fame, and a vice president of football operations for the Canadian Football League. Ed did it all, and our condolences are extended to his wife, Rosemary, and the Jalepka family. After the return by Grant, Bombers starting on the Ticats side of half. And an open target, there's Darvin Adams, who rolls out just short of the first down in the break. My partner said it feels like it's Darvin Adams' time.
Well, it does, because right now the Bombers can put their foot down a little bit. Here's Darvin Adams. They move him into the slot back position. He's usually the wide out to the short side, but he gets a little more room to run that out route. Nice 8-yard gain. He's been the guy for Zach Collaros on the deep ball. Explosion plays in both playoff games were crucial in those wins.
10 catches, 198 yards, and a big touchdown here at McMahon in the two playoff games. Comes up a couple yards short, so Chris Strebler back in. And he'll try the left side. Strebler will run for first down. 6-1, 216. He's alone.
Strebler out to continue the series.
Sixth in rushing during the regular season. Top quarterback running the football. Seven snaps last week against Saskatchewan. Didn't really put a dent in the Riders' defense. Safety Adeleke with the tackle, but Harris having a huge first half. That's 22.
Patty Neufeld is going to make the key block, number 53 up front. He is the guard in the on the offensive line, and he gets that down block to open things up for Andrew Harris, just taking Dylan Wynn and driving him to the ground.
Neufeld traded by Saskatchewan just before the 2013 Grey Cup. And the ball into the end zone. And it's caught! Touchdown! Andrew Harris in traffic.
Don't know that you can cover it any better, but Andrew Harris was the leading rusher and the best tailback in the Canadian Football League, catching the ball out of the backfield, and he makes a beauty right there on the Ticat logo. Rico Murray in the chase position, and Andrew Harris finds the football.
Four rushing touchdowns, four receiving touchdowns in the regular season. One rushing touchdown, one receiving touchdown here in the first half.
Boy, has it been a challenging year for Andrew Harris. suspended for two games. Came back, and he's on a mission tonight. Conference good. Four plays, 50 yards. Harris's fingerprints all over. A Bomber touchdown drive. Well, I know a lot of people can't wait, including my partner Glenn Suter for the Freedom Mobile Halftime Show with Keith Urban. Little chilly, but he's ready to go, and it should be spectacular.
Be yeah, he's going to rock the house tonight. It's going to be great. Big fan of Keith Urban.
How about him coming in and asking Dave Naylor about Willie Jefferson and Brandon Banks? He wanted to get right into it.
Lives down in Nashville, Tennessee Titan fan. This is his first CFL action.
Frankie Williams. Hansen. And you heard that hit all the way back in Germany.
Good to see Frankie Williams. But clearly, the edge in this game, in this first half so far, on defense and the teams in the line of scrimmage, has been the play of the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. They're just a step ahead right now.
It's one of the global players, the former Potsdam Royal. And does he make an impact? Will the Ticats start inside their 25? Good start here. Braylon Addison has a first down. And finally dropped at the 40.
Andrew Harris, five catches so far in this first half. He's got 9 for 80 yards of offense and a touchdown coming out of the backfield and making a nice catch in traffic. He's a man on a mission tonight.
Addison, the first reception by a Ticat other than Banks. First down, Hamilton.
Just a little late on the release. Dane Evans wants to throw it as Banks, I believe, was the intended receiver coming out of his break. And that gave Mike Jones a chance to close on the football. And he's going to come downhill on this one. When Evans had to slide over in the pocket a little bit, negotiate it, it took a little bit of the timing away. Mike Jones had the better crack at it.
And only in the CFL, Mike Jones might be covering Mike Jones here. There's a Mike Jones on either team. And a ball on the turn. They're ruling incomplete. Bombers trying to get on it, but the whistle has sounded. And a demonstrative Andre Prue. But this Bomber defense is getting after Dane Evans. And this time it was Steven Richardson.
Ruling on the field was an incomplete pass. The ends went forward. Incomplete pass.
Dane Evans' arm going forward when the ball is knocked out. So that will be incomplete.
Mike O'Shea might disagree with this.
It's going forward, though, Chris, I think, and it hit the back of his helmet, which is why I think O'Shea, looking from the sideline, probably thought that it might be worth a challenge.
No challenge, though. It's a line drive punt. Grant will scoop it up at the 33. 39-yard punt brings it back about 7. And the momentum with the Bombers, a 12-point lead in the football here with just over 4 minutes remaining in the opening half. Wednesdays on CTV, can you guess the celebrity behind the mask? Get into the Masked Singer, all new December 4th, only on CTV, then stream anytime. Bomber Nation has traveled well. Calaro starts at the 41. And the sweep to Demski. Finds a crease. Got a block from Adams. And back into the Ticat side of the field. That multiple Bomber
and it's Dembski for 23.
When Zach Kolaros first sat down with us when he was a Winnipeg Blue Bomber, I asked him, what do you think of the talent you have around you? You know, guys like Darvin Adams, Andrew Harris, the first guy he mentioned before I talked about anybody was Nick Dembski. He said, I didn't know he was that fast. I didn't know he was that good of a football player. Nick Dembski is a player. Great change of pace runner in that offense, Andrew Harris and Nick Dembski.
The Oak Park boys, here's Harris. More running room for Harris. And down around the 38-yard line. So, 9 for Harris. Tuckle and Brooks, the tackle. But Andrew Harris is providing big first down yardage. That'll get Strebler back into the game. And they're calling the 3-minute warning, 3 minutes to halftime. And of course, that Freedom Mobile halftime show with Keith Urban. Bombers with the lead and with the football when we come back.
You got my back! You got my back!
I got your back!
You got my back!
I say Andrew Harris is ready.
Boy, is he playing like it. Closing in on 100 yards of offense all by himself. And Winnipeg hasn't even gone to play action yet. Excellent success on first down. Over 10 yards on first down so far in the first half.
10 touches, 87 yards, 2 touchdowns. Second and short, Strebler's going to get that. With room to spare, Simone Lawrence trips him up. Just a reminder, coming up next, Grammy Award-winning global superstar Keith Urban takes the stage at the Freedom Mobile halftime show. We'll also hear Ram at the half with Rod and the guys. And James Duthie will check in with Davis Sanchez and the best, Mike Benavides, our coach on the sidelines. Double tight end formation here. Strebler again, crashing off the left side, and down to the 30.
Well, I'm excited, partner, about Keith Urban, and stick with me on this one, but a great offensive coordinator is kind of like a great songwriter. There are essentially 12 notes in Western music, but it's how you put those notes together to make a great song. For an offensive coordinator, there's 12 players on the field, but it's how you put them and how you arrange them that makes a great offense. And right now, Paul LaPolice got his guys rolling. He hasn't even gone to play action where he fakes it to Andrew Harris and tries to go over the top. Mark Washington's got to make some adjustments at halftime.
Looking for a stop here. Second and 6. Kolaros back in. And gets that complete. Coming back for the football, Drew Wolitarski with his first catch of the night. Fastball from Kolaros.
Now it's a laser. And right now you get the feeling that the Hamilton Tiger Cats feeling that pressure, and then all that pressure on the defense to try and hold the Bombers to a field goal attempt here, where this one starts to get away on.
Last 2 cups for Hamilton. They got behind 17-0 in BC in 2014, and of course they got run over at Mosaic in 2011.
Tunde Adeleke there, the safety for Hamilton, was trying to change the play on defense. Trying to get that communicated to the rest of his group. And then Zach Kolaros, I know he thought he
procedure,
had something.
Winnipeg, the whole line moved without the ball being snapped. This is a 5-yard penalty. We're going to replay first down.
Kolaros had him. He had him in a look that he wanted. Adeleke was trying to change it to counter the look, and Zach couldn't get it snapped.
He's out there at the bottom of your screen, and they were going to direct snap to Dembski.
2013 Saskatchewan hosting the Ticats. Valeros with another completion. That is Rasheed Bailey, the catch. He dropped around the 22-yard line.
Big down right here for the Hamilton defense. And they have been under pressure in this one. Lost their defensive end, Julian Hauser.
And now Dylan Wynn's got to come out for three plays. And what a season he has had at defensive tackle.
11 sacks from that interior tackle position. Outstanding year. But this is a big down for Mark Washington. I know we've got a half to play. A lot can happen in Canadian football, as we all know. But there's a handful of plays that make a difference. I would suggest this is one of them. Does he go with full pressure?
There's Pitt athletic therapist Claire Toffelmeyer, who was out onto the field to tend to Dylan Wynn. Looks like he'll be okay. As you mentioned, Suits, big second down play here. Just outside the red zone. As the Bombers try to pad a 12-point lead.
Deep set by Andrew Harris.
Empty it out. Crosser underneath. It is Bailey. And Bailey is brought down around the 12. That's close to a first down. It looks like they're got enough.
Another hit song by Paul LaPolice, because he gets Andrew Harris out of the backfield to help down the field and set a pick that's not called and not seen. Andrew Harris is going to come out. He's an empty backfield there, so Zach Kolaris can dump it to Bailey on the crossing route. And just to the left of your screen, you didn't see it, but the man trying to get to Bailey was cut off by Andrew Harris.
Third red zone. Only we're in the red zone once in the two playoff games. Second and 10. Clock stopped with 40 seconds remaining. Here comes the safety blitz. Kolaris got it away. Adams the catch. And a flag comes down. Adams dropped short. Brooks again on the tackle. Let's check the flag.
It's going to be holding against the Winnipeg Blue Bombers.
To decline that. Buck Pierce, quarterback coach on your right. I love what Mike O'Shea said. We've got the toughest quarterback room by far. No question with Buck Pierce, Zach Kolaris, Chris Strebler, Matt Nichols, and Sean McGuire.
It's a good room, and we should emphasize the input and contribution from Matt Nichols as well.
Offside. Winnipeg, number 89. That penalty's declined. Holding. Winnipeg, number 62. That penalty is declined. The ball will be placed where it went dead at the 9-yard line and a third down.
Cody Speller was called, but penalty declined. Field goal unit comes on. And the Ticats will get the football back one last time in this first half.
That's a big stop. It's a big stop to hold Winnipeg out of the end zone, not give up a major, and all the momentum to the Bombers going in at halftime. When you're reeling like Hamilton is right now, you're looking for anything, and that's a little bit of momentum to hold them to a field goal attempt here by Medlock. Although it is Michael O'Shea, and they are in plus territory.
sure he just wants the three here, but you never know.
You never know with O'Shea. But that is the right decision. Take the points for sure going in at halftime.
O'Shea by 15 against his old buddy, former teammate, Orlando Steinauer on the other side.
I think different styles outwardly, but when they're in their rooms and they're talking to their teams, very similar approaches. Honest, upfront, tell it like it is, get the best out of their guys. Quite a journey for both. Great friends.
So what does Hamilton do in the late stages of this first half? They start with Tyrell Sutton. He's run all the way to midfield and with 6 seconds to go.
Now you take a shot. Now you not a shot at the end zone, but you take a shot at an intermediate throw, maybe 15 yards if you're efficient here. Dane Evans got to get a snap though.
Yeah, they've got to be very efficient.
They're going to blow it in right now. Get that out on a quick out. Might get a chance to kick a long one.
Yeah. It comes down to this. Take a shot. Underneath for Axlund. And he is contained. And clock runs out on him. Thought they might take a shot, but they run out of time in the opening half.
Adjustment time for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Team with 15 wins in the regular season, reeling after that first half. That was all Bombers.
Let's go to the sideline. Sarah Orleski's with Andrew Harris.
Touchdowns for yourself as well. What sort of message do you hope you sent in those opening two quarters?
We're going to play relentless today. You know, no quit. We're going to fight for every yard. We'll make big plays. We won't go down. And still got another 30 minutes to do that, though. I'm excited for it.
What do you need to be aware of in that second half?
They're big. They can make big plays on offense. So the second half of that, the second quarter, we sustained drives. We held the ball. And we chewed up a lot of the clock. So we got to do that all the second half, and we should be fine.
Thank you, Andrew.
Thank you.
Let's go to Matthew Schnetti and Dane Evans.
Dane, down 15. A half to go. What has to change?
Yeah, we just got to start executing. That's all it is. They have a good game plan. They're playing hard. We're playing hard. We're just going to execute.
Where do you see the offense starting in the second half? What can you do to get the offense going?
We just make our plays. That's all it is. That's all it comes down to. Right now, we're just making the moment a little bit bigger than it is. We just got to go out there, play ball, have fun.
Thanks, Dave.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, halftime coming up in the 107th Grey Cup. Keith Urban with the Freedom Mobile halftime show. Ram at the half with Rod, Hank, Maddie, and Milt. And, of course, James Duthie along with Davis Sanchez and Mike Benavides. 21-6, Winnipeg, halftime. Get set for the second half of the 107th Grey Cup presented by Shaw. I think a lot of people are stunned by what we saw in that first half.
That was great.
And by what we saw at halftime. But let's go back to the football game and a huge first half for Andrew Harris, but also a big first half suits for the pressure up front by the Winnipeg defense.
Yeah, when you take a look at that first half, first of all, let's start with the line of scrimmage, because you've heard many, many times a game is won and lost on the line of scrimmage. This is an all-star group of offensive linemen for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, and the Winnipeg D-line dominated. From the interior, Drake Nevis, plays by Jackson Jeffcoat and Willie Jefferson. At times, they'd send linebackers. Conwell got involved. Theadric Hansen involved. But that D-line dominated in the first half for the Bombers.
Second half! Second half,
you're cheering
go.
For the Tie Cats. A couple of pieces of encouraging news. They came back from 15 to beat BC, from 13 at halftime to beat Toronto, and against Winnipeg this year in two games, they allowed only 9 second half points.
Football's all about it. adjustments, and we'll see what Orlando Steinauer has for this second half and what Tommy Condell has to try and slow down that Winnipeg pass rush.
Remember, the Bombers won the toss, deferred. They'll get the ball here first in the second half, and that wind has diminished to really not being a factor now at this juncture. It was gusting over 30 clicks an hour at kickoff, now under 10. Which drought ends tonight? Irelahu boots it. Nick Taylor's going to field it. Bring it back across the 35. And now bubbles back, but might have something. Irelahu flushed it back inside. Good return by Nick Taylor. And here comes the star of the first half offensively.
So the Bombers won the line of scrimmage on defense. They also did on offense in that first half. You know they did when you see the numbers for Andrew Harris, who had close to 100 yards of offense in the first half and two touchdowns. They opened up the holes up front. Here's his first score, taking on the tackle from the secondary and finding the end zone, then came out of the backfield, made a nice catch for his second touchdown of the first half. He is eligible for the MVP of this game, and right now he's the front runner. Lots of football to be played.
Jay Langan taking a knee and getting attention, so a brief delay here. Langan, one of the great special teamers for the Ticats in his fifth year out of St. Mary's. While we got a chance, let's salute the Calgary Dinos, the Vanier Cup champions yesterday. 27-13 over the University of Montreal. Silver. And also congratulations to Steve Simmons and Larry Tucker, inducted this morning into the Football Reporters of Canada Hall of Fame. Starting at the 44 and starting with 33. And again, lowers the shoulder against Adelake, and he powers his way for close to 10 again.
Heard Andrew Harris at halftime talking to Sarah Orleski on the sideline and saying, we are going to fight for every inch. They understand the big play ability of the Hamilton Tiger Cats, but Andrew Harris said it at halftime, and now he's showing you what he means. He is going to fight for every single inch. He gets 9 yards here, but he had to take on half the Hamilton defense to get the final two on the run.
Led the league with an average of 6.1 per carry. He's averaging over 10 yards a rush so far tonight. Just short of the first down, so Strebler tied. And a direct snap, Darvin Adams gonna throw to Strebler in the flat. And Carriel Brooks there to read the play, but Strebler's got a catch, and ball Appelese deep into the playbook again.
Oh yeah, direct snap to Darvin Adams, who at times will line up, and just in case there's a fumble up front, Adams right in the middle of your screen, but it goes through the legs of Chris Strebler, and then he becomes the target out to the left side of the formation. A 13-yard gain as Paul Appelese, as you mentioned, he's deep in that playbook now.
Strebler, a touchdown pass, a catch, a couple of rushes. And Calaro's back in, and they keep feeding the ball to a guy that's got a hot hand. Not going to be denied. Justin Tuggle with the tackle, but again, big first down production. Nine more.
13 division all-stars for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, just five for Winnipeg. They're playing with a chip on their shoulder. Look at the guys up front. Just take on their man, open up the hole. Pat Neufeld's having a fantastic game at right guard. Another drive and block. Andrew Harris isn't finding first contact until he gets into the linebacking core, and sometimes a secondary.
Mentioned that trade for Neufeld as Strebler sneaks again in 2013. Just before the trade deadline, when he knew he might be playing for a home team in the Grey Cup for Saskatchewan, he gets traded to Winnipeg, couldn't even bear to watch the game. It's his chance tonight to finally win a Grey Cup.
Boy, and he's playing up front against Ted Laurent and Dylan Wynn, two of the best in the business at defensive tackle. And Andrew Harris and that offensive line for Winnipeg. They're winning the line of scrimmage.
Told me yesterday, Dylan Wynn makes you raise your game. Streffler back in. First and 10. And a great fake. Trying to get the edge. And take it down. Strong tackle. Rico Murray. Streffler took a lick. Frankie Williams also.
Frankie Williams just sacrificed himself to make a play. He took it upon himself here to lower his shoulder. He had Strebler and escorts coming outside. I mean, he's got some blocking help. Watch 37 come flying in there, and without any regard for his well-being, just throws it in there against Strebler, who's got full run, full speed to try and get his defense fired up.
So the starting corner and also the return man for Hamilton injured. Strebler feeling the effects. We'll be right back.
The third quarter is brought to you by Real Canadian Superstore. Shop like a mother.
So Frankie Williams making his way to the sidelines. And Jamal Rule will check into the game.
He'll play that wide side corner.
Second and 7. Up from Kolaros. Downfield, and Wolterski can't hang on. And Jamal Rule, pressed into service, makes a defensive play right off the bat.
Yeah, you got to be prepared. You don't know when your number is going to be called, and it's press coverage for Jamal Rule, who actually led the secondary in interceptions this year with 5 on the season, but a rotation player coming in as the extra DB.
And 3 of the interceptions
against Winnipeg in 2 games, yes.
Tiger Cat teams deep at just about every position. So it's 3rd down, Medlock in. And the special kick ball is brought in. Banks in the end zone in case. The Medlock missed, and Banks didn't run it out. One of the reasons that was the case, Hamilton was a man short on that missed field goal by Medlock. From 39 out. It's 24-6, and now beyond a 2-score lead. Tangerine Raptors basketball keeps on rolling. Wednesday, R.J. Barrett makes his hometown debut when the Raps welcome the Knicks to Scotiabank Arena. Tip-off at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific on TSN. It's go time for this Ticat offense.
Well, they love the explosion play during the regular season. 21 times over 30-yard plays for Dane Evans. 18 to Brandon Banks and Addison. Can he get that going?
That's like dealing. Got Banks, but a great play by Mike Jones stepping up from his corner spot. And Banks slow to get up after his 6th catch.
Problem with those explosion plays, or the lack of them, has been that Dane Evans has not had the time. So they go to the quick passing game, get Brandon Banks out in the flat here, but a big hit from Mike Jones, and Brandon Banks a little slow to get up right on that hip.
Banks to the sideline, 2nd and 5. Receiver set, and it's Acklin the catch, and got away, and Jalen Acklin has a 1st down near midfield. 12-yard pickup for Acklin.
Tommy Condell, offensive coordinator, in there trying to make adjustments. So the first adjustment you see in the 2nd half is getting the ball out of Dane Evans' hands quicker. So he's not bouncing around in the pocket and allowing that pressure to get to him. Those are 2 quick throws.
second catch for Ackland. Now Tyrell Sutton, who had great first half success. Second level of Big Hill will drag him down, but Sutton puts a dent into the defense and is taken down at around the 32-yard line. That's 23 for Tyrell Sutton.
Good running game. We'll get that defensive line for Winnipeg peeking into the backfield. It'll slow the pass rush.
Right back to it. This time up in. Ran into a blocker. Jeffcoat and Nevis are there defensively.
The Jake Goddard nominee for the Hamilton Tiger Cats is Mike Filer. He's number 51, the middle of your screen. And he makes the big block on the Tyrell Sutton play. Just a couple of plays ago, he's out in that second level on Adam Big Hill. That springs Sutton. Big Hill recovers and catches him before he scores.
Derek Jones checks into the defense. His dad, a winner of five Grey Cups with Edmonton. Second and 10, gunned underneath, and Mike Jones comes back to make the catch. And that's his first of the game. And a first down grab. Well, let's call it just short of a first down. That's going to be third and inches.
Bombers got to stop with third and short in the first half.
Just have to pierce the 25. And Evans.
I don't know.
Close. Did he? Had to get across the 25. And the Bombers think they've come up with another stop.
It's going to be a measurement for sure. Evans doesn't like the spot.
Adam Big Hill already running off the field. Yardsticks come on, but based on where they were lined, they had to break the 25-yard line. The ball is on the 25.
No shot. Didn't get there.
Second time tonight. Fourth turnover of the night. And another takeaway for a fired up Bomber defense. Kyrie Wilson, Willie Jefferson with the stop. McMahon still buzzing about that halftime show. What a thrill this is to have Keith Urban with us. You look like you were competing for the Grey Cup. You might get to take the cup home after that.
Oh, Chris, I don't know about that.
It was great.
This has been a fun game to watch, though, because it's a first for me. So.
But you are a football fan.
Yes, but I'm getting a crash course in CFL tonight.
Yep. So yeah. What do you think?
Incredible. Yeah. I mean, this is the best view in the house, of course.
It's pretty good.
So you guys get a good one.
Keith, outstanding performance
at
halftime.
Man.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate that. Unbelievable. Hey, I know you have a history with Canada and this city. One of your first big concerts was at the Saddle Dome.
Yeah,
you have a relationship with this city already.
Very much. And the crowd tonight was amazing. So, yeah, I love playing here.
And it wasn't minus 10 or 15.
No. I was ready for that, too.
Just stick with us as Zach Caleros on a roll and get pushed up by Simone Lawrence.
Some good advertising for that guy. What did he knock down there? Fisherman's Friend?
Hey, thanks for bringing...
Is it Fisherman's Friend? See, it is surprisingly strong. Curiously strong.
Thanks for bringing Carrie with you as well tonight. That was fun.
Yes, her avatar was present tonight.
So, Keith, I understand that you have some new music coming down the pike pretty soon.
Yeah, we're working on quite a bit. It's going to be coming out throughout next year, and then a new album at some point.
And a new Christmas song, too,
yes.
Did I hear?
Yes. I should sing Happy Birthday to you, though.
Second and 11, they send Heat. Walterski on the slant with the catch, but short of the first down. Ticats get a stop, but the punt team will come on.
One of the great aspects of our game, Keith, is that you can, every player on offense can be in motion. The field is so wide, so
yes.
It opens up the game for a lot of passing and big plays down the field.
And then tell me about the rouge.
Yes, single point if you miss the field goal.
Got it. Okay.
We had one tonight.
It's a different thing in the band locker room.
So I've got a couple rapid-fire questions for you, if I can.
Okay.
First of all, I know you're friends. I know you've recorded together. You're a great guitar player.
Thank you.
Love your guitar.
Who's a better guitar player, you or Brad Paisley?
Oh, we're night and day. We're Pepsi and Coke. We're very different.
Okay. The other one is, for me, is if you could pick one of the songs from your library,
yeah,
what's your favorite?
I have different ones for different reasons, but, I mean, I'm grateful for the ones that stick around, you know, and I've been very fortunate to have a few of those. So it's great to see the ones everyone sings along with live, too.
I'm coming to Country Thunder. You're coming back to Calgary,
aren't
you? Oh,
yes, sir. Yes, I am. Be a little bit warmer than tonight, but maybe not. You never know with Calgary, right?
August of 2020, Keith Urban is coming back to Calgary for Country Thunder.
Good to see Frankie Williams on that return, so he's okay. And so is Braylon Addison with a nice run up the middle, across midfield and into Winnipeg territory. That's crossing the 55-yard line, which you probably haven't seen before.
Definitely haven't seen that. It's not a phrase I hear.
So we're gonna introduce you to color analysis.
Okay.
So on this next play, Dane Evans is the quarterback for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, and let's see. You break it down for us and tell us what you're seeing here.
What am I seeing?
In the shotgun.
Okay.
Little motion. That's that unlimited motion you can put together in Canada.
Right. Catch for Acklin. Down around the 43, that's close to nine.
It moves quick, doesn't it?
Yes,
it's about as quick as we were getting ready to play.
If we had a question for you, both teams have to do extensive scouting. Do you scout halftime shows to get ready for what you're going to deal with here at McMahon?
I love that we could play a lot last night right here. We did several run-throughs last night. It was great to get a feel for the stadium, because I've never been here before. This crowd is amazing tonight. Such good energy out there.
Do you sense that you're getting a taste of Canadiana? This is the biggest all-Canadian event every year.
Yes.
And fans from right across the country, not only watching on TV, but here at McMahon.
Yeah, it's epic. And it's incredible to be here.
First and 10. Tigers trying to cut into this lead. Evans with the keeper. Actually bounced off Braylon Addison on the fake. And has 4 yards. This is a big drive for Hamilton. The favorites, Keith, coming into the game.
That's right.
They need to.
Yeah, this is a surprise turnaround for a lot of people, right?
It is. We have a saying that no lead is safe in a football league.
Right. In any
leads
league,
can
right?
disappear in a hurry.
Yeah, I hear you.
I think Luke Tasker dropped that one.
And that doesn't happen very much.
His dad, Steve, played for the Buffalo Bills for
goodness
most of his NFL career.
Do you think there's some drinking going on in Winnipeg right about now? As opposed to...
Now that's cutting to the chase.
You can guarantee they're celebrating right now. There's still some time to go.
Yes, there
here.
Is.
A quarter of a bit to yeah. go here, but yeah, it's been a long time. Hey, listen, you set
years,
a new
right?
yeah, you set a new standard, Keith, and it's absolutely fantastic to meet you. I am a huge, huge fan.
Thank you, Glenn.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you so much. What a
fake on here. Got a little toss inside. Oh, Luke Tasker has a first down. Jesse breaks the tackle of the Ticats. Not going to settle for three here. Down by 18.
Well, they're going to keep scrapping. They're going to keep fighting. This is Steel Town at its best. Little fake and scoop underneath to Luke Tasker around the edge, and that may be a touchdown saving tackle.
12 yards, Jeff Reinbold, the special teams coach, likes that. Evans, short drop, second look.
No way.
Down to the corner, and Acklin's got the catch.
Is it out?
First and goal inside the five.
Take a look at the replay, because Keith Urban,
right,
yeah, Keith Urban wants to know. Now in the NFL, you need 2 feet in.
Right.
In the Canadian Football League, you just need one. So let's take a look okay. and see if Acklin, on this out route, he gets that
he
right
got,
foot
yeah,
down.
Yeah,
he got them both down.
Yeah, he did.
19-yard connection, first and goal. And a bomber taking a knee. That's Nick Taylor in some difficulty. And Keith, we're going to step aside. What a pleasure to have you in the booth, and everybody across Canada wowed by your performance.
Thank
tonight.
You, Chris. I so
Cheers.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Keith.
Thank
and,
you
I, and I can tell all my buddies, Keith Urban saying happy birthday.
That's
unbelievable.
Right. I'll be back next year.
We'll see you at Country Thunder.
You got it, brother.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Special thanks to Keith Urban. What a night here in Calgary.
Commentator Outdoor Clothing is provided by Nobis. Embrace the elements.
First and goal at the four. Taylor to the sidelines. Brandon Alexander moves into his spot. Derek Jones in at safety. Seventh play of the drive. Backhands try to close the gap. Reset from Evans. Here they come. Breland Anderson. Addison. Touchdown. Got to the corner. And in for the Ticat Major. Their first of the night.
Desperate times call for desperate measures. And fake on third down just to keep the drive alive. And all of a sudden, Hamilton's got a spark. Swings out again, the adjustment made by Tommy Condell to get the ball out of Dane Evans' hands quicker in this second half. That started the drive. That quick throw to Addison caps it off.
Mike O'Shea concerned about a pick on the play, but no flag thrown, and they'll go for two. Best two-point convert team in the league. Evans couldn't find anybody initially. Now to the back. Broken up, intended for Acklin, and Kyrie Wilson is able to knock it loose.
What a great second half to the year for Kyrie Wilson. Big play there on the two-point convert.
But the Ticats get a major. They get it back to within 12 as Braylon Addison hits pay dirt. Check our game leaders tonight. Brought to you by the Real Canadian Superstore.
There's the quarterbacks, 13 to 20, 154. A lot of those yards on that last drive for Dane Evans. Zach Kalaus, good first half. Andrew Harris been the story in the first half. Can Tyrell Sutton take some of that spotlight in this second? Brandon Banks banged up.
Touchdown drive, seven plays, 65 yards. Short kick here. Fielded up across the 35-yard line. And that was a good play by Thomas Miles, the University of Manitoba product, to keep it in the hands of the Bombers.
Let's show you what Michael O'Shea was upset with on this play to Addison coming out on that swing pass. Number 86 coming from the right of your screen. There's Acklin coming down on Mercy Maston, and there's the contact right here. That's a pick and a missed call. Addison gets outside, gets the corner, and scores. But with Hamilton that deep, Mike O'Shea didn't want to use his challenge right there. You only get one.
No big drive here for the Bombers. See how they respond after the Hamilton touchdown. Four for Harris. The delegate on the tackle.
Well, because they had the run game going in that first half, they dominated the time of possession. As the panel mentioned, that took some possessions away from Dane Evans, who finally got a bit of a rhythm on that last one. So a long drive here from Kalaros goes a long way to taking them back out of it.
Ticats have other plans. They've got Dylan Wynn back in the defense and Frankie Williams as well. Second and six. Dembski was in motion. Pocket collapsing. Open target. And Wolitarski's got a first down. And more down inside the 40-yard line. But a good night for Wolitarski. Third catch. in this one for 26.
Now, I don't want to get Bomber fans mad because I'm going to have to check to see if Addison was behind the line of scrimmage. If he was on that play, on that pick, that was going to be a screen, which is legal to make that play downfield. And this is what Collaros needed to do to take back that momentum. A couple plays down the field, move the chains, take away some momentum from that touchdown drive. It is legal to make that block by Acklin if the ball's thrown behind the line of scrimmage.
Double tight ends. Andrew Harris sidestepped Leon Rush of Molden and is spilled down inside the 35-yard line. Harris up to 78 yards on 9 carries.
Couple of uneasy looks to the clock for Coach Steinauer, the coach of the year in the Canadian Football League.
Bombers trying to drain the clock in the third quarter. Perhaps add to this lead. Screen getting set up for Dembski. Can he get outside? And he'll get wrestled down short of the first down. It's a good defensive play by Carriel Brooks.
I'm going to go back to that touchdown just to make sure, because I know Bomber fans are wondering. Number 86 is right here. That's Braylon Addison right there. Now let's see if he's behind the line of scrimmage. The line of scrimmage is the 4. The ball is caught at the 10. So that is behind the line of scrimmage. It is legal for Jalen Acklin to come downhill and make that pick. Great play and execution by the Hamilton offense. And O'Shea got the explanation on the sideline, and that's why he didn't challenge.
Call it a 41-yard attempt here. Midlock straight down the middle. 27-12. It'll be a 15-point Winnipeg lead heading to the fourth quarter of the 107th Grey Cup game. So 6 points on 2 field goals for Winnipeg. An unconverted touchdown for the Tiger Cats. Still 15 heading to the fourth quarter.
Yeah, that was a 65-yard drive by Dane Evans. So that's the positive for Hamilton. Positive for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers is that they answered it with a field goal. So they eat up more time of possession. The question now is, can the Hamilton Tiger Cats come back from the 4 turnovers? Because they've been chasing since the beginning of this game.
It looks like their offense is going, but they need some stops now because Winnipeg has scored on 5 of their last 6 possessions. I have one other question.
Okay.
How did we not get Shania Twain in the booth? Yeah.
That's a good one. That was outstanding.
Ticats off for the kickoff here. Fakes the reverse. And the Bombers not fooled. Mike Jones there with the stick. Mike Miller, the top special teams cover guy, there as well. As we go to the sidelines, here's Matthew Schinetti.
Not good news, CC. Brandon Banks is out. The team is saying it's a lower body injury. We observed him looking at his hip area. He was in a lot of discomfort. Went to the locker room. He will not return. Guys.
Huge news. And a huge blow for the Tiger Cats. The MOP no longer available.
The MOP, who for that first quarter was really the only target for Dane Evans.
Might lean on Addison, but here's Evans throwing incomplete. Looking downfield for him. Sutton out of the backfield.
Real difference on first down. Dane Evans got in trouble, so now he goes to second and long. And this is where it plays to the hands of a strong Winnipeg defense. Jackson Jeffcoat, Willie Jefferson getting up the field on second and long.
crowd sound from the Bombers. Here's Evans downfield, and he's got Jalen Eklund. And Eklund all the way across midfield, stepping up in place of the injured Brandon Banks.
Little action that takes the attention away from this slant throw, this inside dig route right over the middle, right at the logo. And he's going outside now, Eklund. Pushes Taylor to that outside, man, and 35-yard gain over the middle. Big one to get him out of that bad field position.
35 yards, and now Sutton. And Tyrell Sutton with the flag coming down. And he will not be denied. What a great run. Let's see if the flag impacts the play.
Holding Hamilton 84. 10-yard penalty. We're going to replay first down.
That is the first penalty of the night against the Ticats. Nikola Kalinic, the rookie out of York.
Yeah, Kalinic has played that tight end, and he's up against Willie Jefferson, the defensive player of the year. As he's coming around, he comes from that backside. He gets on the shoulder and then turns Jefferson right at the point of attack.
First and 20. It's Addison. Braylon Addison, a quarterback, running back in high school, running back receiver at Oregon, and a guy that is a natural runner, even though he is a tremendous pass receiver in the Canadian Football League.
Now, one of the challenges for Dean Evans now is getting in and out of the huddle efficiently. You may even see Tommy Condell, the offensive coordinator, go to hurry-up offense in that tempo game. The clock is the enemy as well.
Second and 11. Here come the Bombers, but Evans stands in. Fires. Watts Jones. Got him. And he dropped the ball inside the five. Had it, but couldn't control it as he hit the turf.
Boy, he split the defenders, got in behind Brandon Alexander, the safety, and Mike Jones, the corner, turns. That ball comes out on the way down. Now, that's in super slow motion. In real time, ruled incomplete.
And it looked like Mike Jones knocked it out of his hands as he was going down. There's that Mike Jones versus Mike Jones matchup. And Evans nearly had the big home run play that the Ticats need.
And this will be the second Ticat receiver out. Now let's look at it at regular speed, because you've got to have control of the football and survive the contact. It's a strip or a knockdown.
So Banks already out, and you saw Jones grab the left shoulder. And that receiving corps getting thinner. Dean Evans, you just saw on target. He's a guy that can stretch the field.
Oh, yeah.
One of the strongest arms in pro football. In fact, only Josh Allen has ever been registered at a higher miles per hour than Dean Evans, who's been clocked at 63 miles an hour.
University of Tulsa, he threw for over 11,000 yards.
And the punt goes out of bounds on the hop outside the 20-yard line. So 12:36 to go. 15-point Winnipeg lead.
Medication, the brand new album by John Party. Listen on Spotify.
Be some jubilation and some heartache tonight. It's always one of our favorite parts of the Grey Cup game.
I get emotional. When that thing comes down, I mean, there's nothing more Canadian than the 107th Grey Cup championship with the Mounties bringing the cup into the building.
November chills here at McMahon. closer look than they've had for a long time. Still some work to do. We should have told Keith the one thing we've got in Canada are trophies you can drink out of. Here, Dembski. And Dembski's got the catch beyond the 50. There's one of those Oak Park guys.
The homegrown Manitoba guys are coming through. Andrew Harris and Nick Dembski. Get out of the hole. Hamilton needed the two and out there. Get out of the hole. And Zach Collaros, who's been on this stage before, back in 2014 as a member of the Ticats, is not fazed by the pressure. He lets it go. 41-yarder. Dembski with a nice catch at the top end.
Clutch catch puts the Bombers over 200 passing yards. Winnipeg last in the league this year in passing. That's a rarity for a team to go to the cup as the last place passing team. Part of their success is because of this guy, and he's not going to be denied tonight. Andrew Harris wants to get his hands on that.
Get your attention, get your pictures, get your selfies. And
you see that one woman's reaction?
And the Winnipeg
dropping.
Winnipeg Blue Bombers want to get their name on it.
Trophy's going to get a standing ovation.
There is plenty of time in this football game, but Hamilton needs to stop, and they need it now.
Nine more on first down for Harris, which brings Chris Strebler back into the game. And Strebler break behind Cody Speller. Should be a first down.
Strebler's been playing through the playoffs on the bad ankle. Gets up limping after every run and then gets back in there and does it again. And that's why Michael O'Shea said he feels like he has the toughest quarterback room, as you mentioned, off the top. That's just a battering ram at quarterback, number 17. Reminds me of our colleague, Matt Dunnigan. Matty could obviously throw it like Zach and run it like Chris Strebler. There he is watching on.
First and 10. And the jet inside to Dembski. Sidestepped one. Got away. And Dembski running for another first down.
They can feel it. The Winnipeg Blue Bombers can taste this. You see it in the jump in their step. You see it in the second effort.
And now Rico Murray, slow to get up.
Got to continue to keep their composure. The Jamarcus Hardrick, 4 years with the Winnipeg Blue Bombers at that right tackle position. He's the lead blocker coming out and around for Nick Dembski, who breaks a couple of blocks. No tackles.
So two guys from the same high school in Winnipeg have combined for 189 yards and two touchdowns in the Grey Cup game. Homegrown. Rico Murray still down. Guy who is playing in his fifth cup, third consecutive. And he gets attention, so we will step aside. Into the fourth quarter. Time now for the Shaw connection of the game. Speed, coverage, control. Shaw Blueford.
Well, the Hamilton Tiger Cats have been chasing this game because of the play of Andrew Harris. This is the connection of the game so far, with Harris over the top for one of his two touchdowns. Also has a rushing major, both in the first half.
The wait's been 29 years. Remember that 1990 game? They blew out the Edmonton Eskimos, a game that I thought everybody expected would be close. Second and inches, and with a flag down, Strebler sneaks ahead. Thirtieth postseason game for Michael O'Shea as a player, assistant, and now as a head coach.
offside. Hamilton defensive line, 97, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Ted Laurent lining up in that 1-yard restraining area. Tonight in Calgary, what a week it's been. Are we in for a finish, or are the Bombers going to finish off the Cats here? Strebler to the keeper. Dropped at the 30. So a huge play now for the Ticats. Looking to put a halt to the drive.
Strebler is going to try and work his way off the field here. He's all banged up, but it's a late flag on the play.
Boy, he's been fighting through this for a month, hasn't he?
After the play was over, objectionable conduct, Winnipeg number 17, a 10-yard penalty will be enforced from the end of the play, and it will be second down.
Did he react to something that happened at the bottom of the pile and get caught doing it? Down there at the bottom. That's Dylan Wynn. He didn't like whatever Wynn did to the...
Yep.
Couldn't really see something he said or something he did to his knee. Didn't like that. Draws a penalty.
Now makes it second and 17.
Doors open for this Hamilton defense right here.
Making it a tougher field goal attempt unless they get something here. Harris gets back into field goal range. But he's got more. How about Andrew Harris tonight?
Wow.
And he's eligible for all the awards tonight.
Great blocks up front, like he's seen all night. But it's what he does when he gets to the second level. Andrew Harris, look at the hole he's got to run through. That's control. Scrimmage from the O-line, but then he does the rest, bobbing and weaving through the linebacking core and then just taking the secondary with him, and there's nothing Mark Washington can do about it.
Reminds me of Corey Sheets, 2013, a draw play on second and 19. He got 20. Harris again. Tuckle there to drag him down inside the 10. But Andrew Harris, over 100 yards on the night, 5 times during the regular season. But a monster night.
Pat Neufeld, Drew Desjarlais, Stanley Bryant, Cody Speller up front at center. Jamarcus Harvard, that's a great D-line in Hamilton. They dominated tonight.
Second and 5. Just get the play off. Open in the end zone. Bailey. Touchdown. Bomber sets it now.
Take a taste it.
First Canadian Football League touchdown for Rashid Bailey.
Mark Washington, this is the call that you're throwing your hands up a little bit, because he sent everybody he's got and left his secondary in one-on-ones with no help in the back end, and Rashid Bailey on the corner route for the touchdown.
6 scores in the last 7 possessions for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. Against the number one ranked defense in the league this year.
Well, and the number one team with 15 wins. I mean, all of our panel members predicted the Hamilton Tiger Cats at the beginning of the season would be in the cup. 15 wins, even when they lost Jeremiah Masoli, and Dane Evans continued to progress. But this Winnipeg Blue Bomber team started 5-0. But look, they're going to review this, because did he have control?
And does he trap it? He may have.
Does that constitute control? Every touchdown is reviewed.
The previous play is under review by the command center.
Bro, a little loose, and is that a trap in the hands of the command center here on?
Because Bailey jumped for the ball, he's got to survive the contact with the turf on his way down. So he's in the air now when the ball hits his hands and it's loose going to the ground. This will be interesting.
Well, they can't get better replays. All the evidence is there. Now the command center got to make a decision. Call on the field was touchdown.
And the mandate from about midseason with the command center is that they have to see a clear and obvious mistake to overturn a call. But I think he trapped it. It looked like, and upon review,
did look like it.
Did he have control because he needed to survive contact?
Taking a long time, but let's find out.
It came from the bottom all the way to the top. We're about to win this thing, man. We're waiting all day. After a review by the command center, the ruling on the field is overturned to an incomplete pass. It will be third down, 6 yards to go from the 10-yard line. Third down.
Touchdown comes off the board.
Well, you got to give credit to Brooks, the halfback, on that play to keep hustling and stay with it, because Bailey had this caught at the top of the jump, but that push right there jarred it loose, and then he had to survive contact to get possession, and that's the reaction. But the right call from the command center.
Been a long wait, and they're going to have to wait a little longer.
But still an important field goal.
Yes. And they took a lot of time off the clock and could get it beyond a two-possession game.
Yeah, this makes it a three-possession game, which is very important, even though it's a chip shot for Justin Medlock.
So it's 30-12. 6:12 left. Is this the night the drought ends for Winnipeg? Back at McMahon, let's take the temperature on the sidelines first. Sarah Orleski.
Well, Chris, there was obvious excitement on the sideline when they felt that they had the touchdown, but it's been very even keel all game over here. That's something that they've really stressed throughout these playoffs. The message right now, just do your job. Now, for more on the Ticats, let's go to Matthew Schinetti.
Well, let's go to the other side of that. Almost touchdown, Sarah, when that was overturned. Chris Van Zyl turned to his teammates and said, let's go now. A team, and I've seen them all season, that looks deflated, is trying to get any kind of hope, CeCe.
Well, we've seen big leads disappear in a hurry in the Canadian Football League, and we've seen two score leads disappear inside 3 minutes, so 6:12 to go.
And remember, no Brandon Banks for the Hamilton offense.
Addison drops back on the kick return. Ticats got to empty the tank now. Frankie Williams. Good return. And then a big hit at the end of it. Achin Goche, one of the heroes last week, a guy who saved a potential game-tying touchdown by Nick Marshall on a punt return.
It's been a physical game. The Bombers have had the edge there. When you win the line of scrimmage, it's because you're more physical. We've seen some big hits on the teams. That's a nice return from Frankie Williams, but Goche with a solid hit.
He didn't track down Nick Marshall last week. They might not be here. Ticats start at the 43. Look out, Willie Jefferson. Strip. Ball loose. And it looks like Chiracco got back on it. There's number five doing what Willie Jefferson does. And Evans has been hurt.
Jefferson with that long reach. Uses it one more time. He's got the ball on both edges, one coming from the left, one coming from the right. Take a look at the right side, though, the big swim move, getting that right hand and arm up and over, and then around the corner to Dane Evans, strips the ball one more time with that great swim move. Left hand to the shoulder pad, right hand over the top.
Led with six forced fumbles during the regular season, two tonight, and Evans had a step knocked out of his hands by Jackson Jeffcoat. The bookends on back-to-back plays.
We're seeing the cheetah formation for Winnipeg. Cheetah is their version of all defensive ends in the defensive line, and this time it's going to be Jackson Jeffcoat. His dad, Jim, former Dallas Cowboy, is in attendance, and Jeffcoat with three-man pressure, all defensive ends, even combo in the middle, pushes upfield, that big reach to get the ball out of Dane Evans' hands.
Play, as all turnovers or potential turnovers are under review, Jim Jeffcoat's always told his son to be his own man. He has two Super Bowl rings, and Jackson's got his eye on a Grey Cup ring here tonight.
I talked to Jackson about his dad during the work week, and he told me, well, my mom Tammy is probably pushes me harder. Tammy's the one who will watch the games back and say, I need better hustle from the backside. But he said Jim told him, don't be outworked, and this defense has not been outworked tonight.
Those two work out together in Austin, Texas, Jeffcoat and Jefferson. Here's Harris, and he nearly got away down at the 15-yard line.
No more. Incredible pedigree. No more. When you take a look at Dad's accomplishments, Jim Jeffcoat, two-time Super Bowl champion with the Dallas Cowboys, 102.5 career sacks. And son Jackson is this close to his own championship ring.
Former Texas Longhorn. Second and two, and that's Strebler time. Left side, he's got it again. Sarah Leski.
Sticking with the Jackson Jeffcoat and his father, Jim, he told me that the comment that he gets most often from his dad, the message, is that big-time players make big-time plays in big-time games.
Kid got the message, didn't
he? Yeah, he got the message tonight, Sarah. That entire defense did.
Yeah, we were surprised. Those ends weren't a huge factor last week, but what a different story tonight. Valeros back in, first and goal from the 11, and Harris dives ahead for one. Bolden, the tackle, second and nine.
It's been an unbelievable journey, too, for Zach Kolaros when you consider where it started this year. Play number three as a Saskatchewan Roughrider. Sat out the entire season.
Hamilton.
You've heard the story by now, but...
Timer, put 3 minutes, 11 seconds on the clock. 3:11.
But his veteran presence has been a difference maker in this Bomber team. That takes nothing away from Matt Nichols. They were 5-0 when Matt Nichols was the starter. But Zach Kolaros' career is back on track, and it's great to see.
Pride of Steubenville, Ohio. There's his family in attendance. Can you imagine, as a quarterback, learning three different offenses in the same year?
That's his wife, Nicole, with the Bomber toque on the left. And Mom Shelley, Dad Dean, and it is great to see Zach back.
Lamented four or five plays that may have made the difference 5 years ago to win one for Hamilton. Won't be any regrets tonight, I don't think. Harris, and he gets stuffed. The Delacay stepped up and made the tackle. Just shy of the warning here. And they are
going to call the three-minute warning. Bombers are 3 minutes away, up by 18, and Medlock coming on to attempt a field goal.
The 107th Grey Cup is brought to you by Shaw. Speed, coverage, control. Our best Wi-Fi experience. Shaw Blue Curve.
Exactly 3 minutes to go. Bombers have led for 53-04.
The early turnover is just too deep a hole for Hamilton to climb out of. I have the feeling the celebration's already begun in Manitoba.
Three more. Bombers have scored on seven of their last eight possessions. You see the joy from the Winnipeg fans, and the coach of the Blue Bombers well aware of what all this means back home.
And they talk about their relatives that are moving on in age, and they talk about how important it would be to them and how they're hoping that they, those relatives, get an opportunity to witness it. And that's powerful stuff. That's important. I don't think it can make you play better, but it certainly can make you appreciate why those conversations are started.
Andrew Harris understands that. So does Nick Dembski. But you know what? Jamarcus Hardrick, born in Nebraska, says, I'm a Manitoban now. Everybody on that sideline knows what it means, not just to the team, but to everybody in Manitoba.
And they keep the game face on, of course, for the final 2:41. But a little bit of celebration starting on that Winnipeg bench. And boy, it's been a long time coming, and enjoy it. Bomber fans, been waiting a long time.
Might get the gorilla off their back. Addison. Big return could change the mood, but he's contained. Mike Miller, that special teams ace, comes up with another special team tackle.
Well, just one of the great cover guys in the Canadian Football League, a finalist for the Special Teams Player of the Year. Went to Frankie Williams, but I'm real happy to see a guy like Mike Miller, one of the cover guys, one of the grunt players, those heart and soul unsung heroes, be recognized as a finalist, the Special Teams Player of the Year.
One of three Acadia Axemen in the game. Here's Sutton, who's run well tonight. For Sutton, and he's got 84 in the game. But Evans contained to under 200 yards passing. Sutton a first down run.
Now listen, both of these coaches are so similar in building the right culture in their team. Orlando Seinauer has done that with Hamilton. 15 wins in the regular season, a convincing win in the Eastern Final versus the Edmonton Eskimos. He has created that culture. The players love to play for him. He's up front and honest with them. This is a very, very good football team that's got a bright future.
Down he goes. Evans dropped again. Jackson Jeffco on back-to-back series.
Well, they're going to play to the final whistle. Like to get all those DNs in, so if you play an extra DN, you could put Jackson Jeffco in at tackle. And now he's working on Brandon Revenberg, the outstanding Canadian nominee for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. And he blows by him.
Sacks on the night for Winnipeg. Second and 18. Addison the catch up at the 50-yard line, and it will be third and 7. So they came into Calgary 2 weeks ago and held the bold Levi Mitchell Stampeders to 14 points. 13 points all Saskatchewan could muster against Richie Hall's defense. Hamilton's got a dozen tonight. Third and 7 to stay on the field.
at that points allowed total that you just mentioned, Chris, no surprise when it's a team built by Michael O'Shea. Richie Hall gets a ton of credit, the defensive coordinator. It has been a very difficult season for Richie Hall. When he lost his brother Michael midway through the season, Richie Hall has coached this team and this defense with a heavy heart all season long. Talked.
Work's done.
His work is done. Put the briefcase away. You're a champion again, Richie.
Harris to Pettis. Five more. 132 on the ground. 35 receiving.
Timeout.
It just seems
Hamilton.
Just seems so fitting that Michael O'Shea's team wins the line of scrimmage, wins the ground game, and plays great defense. That's linebacker football. That's Michael O'Shea football. That's Willie Jefferson football. That's Bomber football this year.
That'll get you a championship belt. No turnovers for Winnipeg in the postseason. Plus 13. In the postseason,
as underdogs, you want to create turnovers and get the favorite thinking about it. They did that out of the gate, first two series. Hamilton turned the ball over.
Second and five, Harris. Neil Jagera Davis there to stop that. What do they do on third down here?
We're not done yet.
Also mention Nick Dembski one more time. Nick Dembski through the playoffs. There it is. We're going to wait for that final 31. It's over, baby.
He's going to leave the offense out.
Dembski's played his best football through the playoffs, no question.
I think there's a long list of Bombers that can say the same. Third down, they need six. There's the first turnover of the postseason. And Hamilton will take over. You know, Mike O'Shea's one of those guys, when he played, he knew where everybody was. I think he knew this was coming.
Was he aware that he knew it was coming? A good coach is one step ahead. And the Winnipeg Blue Bombers were tonight.
Try to North Bay. And I'm not sure there's anybody in the CFL that loves the Canadian game more than Mike O'Shea. This might be the biggest night of his life. Another sack. Although we asked him, hypothetically, would this be the biggest? And he danced around, and his final comment was, still the best to be a player. But this is pretty good for the old middle linebacker.
Well, the entire organization, Wade Miller, down on the sideline from the spotter's booth celebrating.
Some emotion there, huh?
Saw Danny McManus up with him in the box.
Second and 14. Look out! Another punishing hit. Mike Jones, this is, I think, his best game in the Canadian Football League. Closing and sticking Tyrell Sutton. And you know those preseason prognostications?
Yeah, there's Richie Hall.
I'll be the first to pick Hamilton to be back here next year.
The first team to go on the road, the semifinal team, win the three games and be champion since 2005.
Third and 11. Evans throwing. It's intercepted. It's Mike Jones. What a night for 16. And that allows the Bomber offense to come out and go into victory formation.
one more snap in 2019. They have put the win back in Winnipeg. The Blue Bombers, 2019 Grey Cup champions.
All right, brother.
I'll call you in a bit.
Three sacks for Big Willie Jefferson. Dean Evans under duress all night long.
There is no question this game was won at the line of scrimmage by the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. They won it on offense on the ground. Zach Collaros chipped in with the passes he needed. And their defense dominated.
Nobody has written a more unique script to be a winning quarterback in the Grey Cup than Zach Collaros, and Richie Hall overcome with emotion. Let's go down to the field. Sarah Orleski with the man of the hour tonight.
Well, Chris, I'm joined by a very happy Winnipegger at the moment. Andrew, you know, it's been 29 years since the Bombers last won a Grey Cup. A Winnipeg-born player you are. What does it mean to you, especially as time is winding down? What was going through your mind knowing that you guys had accomplished the goal?
I honestly couldn't believe it. It's surreal right now. I'm so proud of my teammates, my city. I love you guys. Come home with that cup. Woo! It was all game. We were in the zone. I was feeling it, and man, what a great game.
You look like you came out on a mission tonight.
Absolutely. I mean, put a lot of pressure on myself in this game, and you know, I wanted to do something great, be part of something great, and we did it.
What can you say about the job at the line of scrimmage that your team did on both sides?
Our O-line receivers, they were lights out. They were lights out today. There's a lot of times where I was not getting touched first 5 yards, 10 yards, and that's beautiful when that happens.
First people you think of when you know that you've won the Grey Cup?
Oh, man, everyone that taught me along the way, all the haters out there that talk shit, sorry about language, but this is for you.
Thanks so much, Andrew. Congratulations.
Thank you.
To Matthew Schnetti with Zach Collaros.
Zach, could you believe, after everything that's happened this season, that you'd be standing here in Calgary, the quarterback of the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, having won just a great cup?
When the trade happened, yeah, I could believe it.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, when I talked to you 6 weeks ago, there was some questions about where you would go, what would happen. How did you feel this Bomber team accepted you?
I've been saying it all along. It's an amazing group of guys. I'm so happy for everybody. What a team, man. So happy.
In terms of that relationship with Mike O'Shea, what was said before the game to you and Chris Streveler?
O'Shea said, man, you're made for this. That's it.
And in terms of bringing a great cup back to the city of Winnipeg, even though you've only been there for a short time, what does that mean?
It means a lot. It means we're so happy to bring it back for our fans. 29 years, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Get to celebrate, man. It's going to be fun.
Congratulations, Zach.
Thanks. Give me a hug, buddy.
Now over to Sarah Leske with Willie Jefferson.
Willie, you won the Grey Cup in 2015 as a member of the Edmonton Eskimos in Winnipeg at that Grey Cup. How does this one feel different?
It's so much different. It means so much more. I'm so locked in with this team, so in depth with this team, man. These my brothers, man. We fought all year, the ups and the downs, fighting adversity. You know what I'm saying? Going against the CFL, they betting against us. Man, it means everything, man.
How would you describe the mindset of the line tonight? You were able to get so much pressure on Dane Evans from the beginning.
Man, relentless pressure. Whatever we had to do to get back there, to make him uneasy, to make him feel uncomfortable, that's what we was doing all night. Three-man rush.
You told me yesterday that this was more than just a football game for you guys. This was about the city, the fans as well. Can you imagine the celebration that is going on in Winnipeg?
Most definitely, man. Y'all say some of that for us when we get back, man. Say some of that for us, man. It's been a long time coming. Hey, my homeboy that's been waiting to wear them pants, go ahead and strap them on, man. It's going down.
Congratulations, Willie.
Man, come on down to Winnipeg, man. Come on down to Winnipeg.
Let's head to Matthew Schneider with Nick Dembski.
Well, Nick Dembski's enjoying himself right now. All his teammates are calling him a legend. Nick. Nick, very quickly. The party doesn't stop. Nick. How much more does this mean to Winnipeg boy like you and Andrew Harris? What was the conversation like before the game?
Before the game, man, we just looked each other in the eyes. We knew what we had to do. You know, it wasn't really much words. It was just, you know, put on for a city. Let's bring this thing home.
Well, I'm going to talk to you. Look in that camera right now.
Yeah.
There are hundreds of thousands of Blue Bomber fans.
Yes, sir.
Manitoba people. What is the message to the promise of Manitoba?
We're coming home, champs. Let's go, man. That's all I got. I'm lost for words. I'm just so happy, so proud of this team. You know, thank you for believing us and sticking with us. We're coming home as champs, man.
And to know that it was you and Andrew Harris who wrote that story, how much more does that mean?
You know, it was this whole team. It was a team effort. Through all the ups and downs, adversity, man, we stuck together. This team, I'm going to remember this team forever. And you know, it really is a cherry on top being champs. But, you know, being from Winnipeg, all these Winnipeg boys, man, we just, you know, this is a conversation to start of the year. We made it happen, made it come true. You know, I just couldn't be more proud of this team. You know, I love this city. I'm just happy to be bringing this Grey Cup home.
Nick Dembski, Winnipeg Blue Bomber, Grey Cup champ. Thanks for
sir, thank you.
Two guys from the same high school in Winnipeg combined 236 yards and two touchdowns tonight.
Zach Kolaris and that veteran presence coming in late. Went three games in the playoffs at 65%. Threw a couple of touchdowns, 3-0, did not throw an interception. That veteran presence, so important to the Bombers' final push to the Grey Cup Championship.
So was the 1-2 punch at quarterback here,
no
Sarah,
question.
With Chris Trepler.
Chris, what does this mean to you?
I can't even put it into words. I just love this group of guys, these coaches, guys that have fought all year, and love putting it on the line for the person next to them.
Was there any doubt in your mind, that you would be able to finish this game?
No. I mean, the whole season, it's just guys laying it on the line for the teammates, and it's just, you want to be out there. This is the Grey Cup. This is the Grey Cup. No.
Congratulations. Enjoy the parade when it happens.
Thank you so much.
And so, a win for the W. Welcome to the 2019 Grey Cup Awards and Trophy Presentation. To present the awards for Most Outstanding Canadian and Most Outstanding Player, the President of Shaw Communications, Brad Shaw, and your host, James Duffy.
Thank you, Rod. First of all, thank you to Calgary for your passion, your hospitality, and your great weather all week long. The outstanding player of the 2019 Grey Cup from the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, Andrew Harris. The Winnipeg Blue Bombers won the Grey Cup. You came back to Winnipeg because you wanted to end the drought for your hometown team. What does it mean to be such a big part of it?
Oh man, it's a dream come true. I mean,
part of that game, you know, just envisioning, you know, you want to come do something, you put your mind to it, you set goals, and to accomplish it, it's amazing. So proud of my teammates, so proud of my city, my friends and family. It's an amazing day today.
You won the Grey Cup in 2011 in your first year as a regular running back, and you said it almost felt like it came too easy. And you said this week the years in between have taught you how hard it is. Does that make this one sweeter?
This is the sweetest thing I've ever tasted in my life right now. So, hey, 204 Peck City, we did it, man.
You had a brilliant season, your third straight rushing title. But I know the two-game suspension frustrated you, hurt you, angered you. Did it also motivate you because you look like a man possessed today?
These two trophies and that one behind, that's for all the haters that put me down, Kiko and I down. All right? So stick both these trophies. You know it.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you, man.
Andrew Harris, the most outstanding Canadian and the most outstanding player. Once again, that is the first time that the outstanding Canadian has also been the outstanding player in the Grey Cup. And now, Winnipeg, the moment you have waited for 29 years, to present the Grey Cup, the commissioner of the Canadian Football League, Randy Ambrosi.
Well, on behalf of the Canadian Football League, our Board of Governors, and all of our fans, it is my honor and privilege to present the 2019 Grey Cup presented by Shaw to the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, Grey Cup champions.
Whenever you tell me. Here's the Grey Cup champion coach, Mike O'Shea. Your time here has been like a staircase, missing the playoffs the first 2 years, losing the semis the next two, losing the final last year. How does the top of the staircase feel?
Oh, pretty good right now. I mean, it's going to take a little while to sink in, really. I'm just happy for our guys, obviously. You know, to play such a good game when it mattered most, I think that's really impressive. It's a great learning spot for them, right? I mean, they've learned all year. We've faced a lot of adversity. And then to come out and play your best when it really mattered, it's really impressive.
It's an incredible run, the two big wins on the road. And then you go in against the team that was 15-3, number one offense in the CFL, number one defense in the CFL. Without too many schematic X and O details, how did you do it?
Willpower. I'm telling you, our defensive front and our offensive line, I think our fronts control the line of scrimmage pretty well. So they got after the quarterback real well. I mean, Dane Evans can throw the rock. They got a lot of weapons. And to neutralize him with a lot of pressure was fantastic. And then we were able to run the ball a little bit. So, yeah, I mean, all three phases performed very well.
Your third Grey Cup, but your first as a head coach. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Suits, that trophy presentation was vintage Mike O'Shea. He selected Jake Thomas, the longest serving Winnipeg Blue Bomber, to accept the trophy. He told us the other day the highlight for him as a player was watching Jude St. John lift the cup after 10 years in the league for the first time. And it's delight for Jake Thomas to hold the cup first for the Bombers after a 29-year wait.
Former Acadia Axeman told me yesterday he hopes that we play CFL football in Halifax. He said they're ready, and he's an eight-year veteran with the Bombers. It is so Michael O'Shea to allow him to take the trophy first.
party started in Winnipeg. It has started in Douglas, New Brunswick, just outside of Fredericton, Jake Thomas's hometown. Much more from an emotional post-game ceremony here at McMahon.